Hi guys, good morning all of you. Today we are going to look at the topic called Error Recovery in Predictive Parsing. Otherwise it is called as LL1 Parsing. What are all the way errors are recovered? Auto recovery mechanism only we are speaking about. If something, a slight mistake happened or committed by the user while writing a program, how we can take care of that, how the compiler is taking care of such error, automatic correction, error recovery mechanism. That is what the aim of the topic, how it is going to recover. When that kind of error will occur is the second question. When the terminal on the top of the stack does not match the input symbol. Already we discussed, there are two parts. One is stack is one content, all the time we will discuss. Another time we will discuss input buffer. This is what two data structure we used to take. Always we used to look at top of the stack symbol, and always we look at leftmost symbol of the input, we can say, or input buffer, whatever. So this is how we used to scan the work, we used to do the job. When these two things are happening, how we need to address? Now look at, again read, when the terminal on the top of the stack symbol and the input symbol under consideration, these two are not matching. This is what one type of error. This is called one type of error. What are all the possible errors we will be facing is the first point of discussion. Next only we can think of how the error can be recovered automatically. First we need to understand when the input or when the error situation will occur. Whenever this mismatch happens, that is one type of error. There is another type of error. What is that another type of error is? Always we will make a pair. This is what I discussed in the last class. Non-terminal capital A, terminal A. A, we will look at the row, and this symbol, we will look at the column. This is simple term. It's table of row, comma, column. This is what they are technically talking. Nothing more. You just understand there is a table you have. You will be looking at the row and the column. When that row and the column happens to become empty, that is another error. See, empty means what? You and me don't know what to do. If some entry is there, we used to replace, we used to do some other activity. That top of the symbol is replaced by right and RHS of the production. Itself, what you and me can do, compiler also cannot do anything. So in that circumstances, how we are going to handle? One is mismatch. Top of the stack is ID, input symbol may be something else different, plus symbol. There is two symbols are matched, we used to remove from both of the data structure. You would have noticed ID matches. What I used to do? Remove, pop the symbol from the stack, remove the symbol from the input buffer. Plus and plus matches. We used to pop the symbol from the stack, we used to remove the symbol from the input buffer. When the two terminals are matching all the time, we used to remove, we do the removal process. That is fantastic case. Now first error, what it says, there is no match at all. That is our first problem. Where the other problem will rise, we are trying for looking into the entry of the table row and column, some row, some column. But if you are looking at that cell, that cell is happened to become empty. What is the meaning of empty? No decision computer can take. Computer cannot even understand that emptiness. So that now we need to fill those entries. That is what our duty. Whatever we take action, but we must have an action, not it should become empty. When it becomes empty, non-trivial solution. Computer cannot do anything. Now that is what the prime duty of error recovery. Although the topic is error recovery, indirectly what we are trying to do is, the moment you design LL1 table or predictive parse table, your responsibility is not to leave any of the cell with emptiness. You need to take care of filling each and every entry. Now, how to fill those entries? Let us see. That is what the interesting topic of today's discussion. We know so far now, one non-terminal and terminal, looking at the first or looking at follow, somehow we used to fill that entry. That part is quite comfortable. Beyond that, I didn't explain to you anything. There are several cells we used to leave it as empty. Now, how to take care of that empty cells is what the interesting topic of discussion, although the topic states that error recovery mechanism. To be simple, or in order to understand by a common layman, we already know the strategy to design LR1 parts table. We know how to feed the entries. Now, beyond that entries, there are several cells happen to become empty. How to take care of that emptiness? Because computer cannot understand emptiness. That part we need to remember all the time. Now let us go ahead. There are two types of error recovery mechanism. One is panic mode error recovery, phrase level recovery. Don't by heart anything, you will understand. When I explain, when the problems are solved, you will understand. Panic mode recovery, phrase level recovery mechanism. Then, what we are going to do with the panic mode recovery? That recovery means what? Something goes wrong. Even in our day-to-day life, something goes wrong. We will be recovering from that situation, whether financial matter or whatever may be the matter. We will be trying to recover from that situation. So there is a panic mode recovery. How to means panic mode error, then how to recover? That is what the another topic of discussion. From this point onwards, no more theory. Let us go to the solvation, then you will understand the interpretation of every line. If I start trying to tell you, you may understand, may not understand. With the introduction, when the error will happen, types of error, panic mode recovery, phrase level recovery, directly I am going to illustrate through problem how these recovery strategies are solved. This one, especially this point. Then these are all other points we need to solve. There is already solved problem I have. I'll walk through later this also. Let us start the fresh problem of starting. For this context, there is a grammar CFG, following CFG grammar, it is given. We need to do the error recovery strategies for this grammar. Given the grammar, you need to look at. Now I give you explanation. This is the one symbol you may look at newly. This is called exponential symbol. Let me give the annotation here. This cap, I mean to say exponential. You all know that PEMDAS rule. PEMDAS rule states that what? Parenthesis. This is called PEMDAS rule. PEMDAS, just a short form, just for rhyming, people have kept the PEMDAS rule. That is, it's not at all a technical. What is the PEMDAS rule says is precedence. That precedence is what? P stands for parenthesis, highest precedence. E stands for exponential, that is power function, 2 to the power of 5, 3 to the power of 6, that kind of operator. Exponential, multiplication, division, addition, subtraction. This is what you need to remember all the time, PEMDAS rule. This PEMDAS rule always helpful for us in solving, in understanding the priority, operator precedence, that the power of the operators. Among several operators, we can understand the power of each and every operator. The priority, yes, exactly, Pavan, parenthesis, exponentiation, multiplication, that is the PEMDAS rule. That's it. Now with that introduction, Pavan need to articulate first for these all. Slowly you do, because I also need to type. You start telling me first for E, subsequently E dash. You should say, tell me that first of E, first of E dash, first of T dash, like that you tell.
Ma'am, good morning, ma'am. This is Pavan. Yes.
Good morning.
First of E is, it starts with T now, ma'am. Then we need to look for T production, ma'am. Then T production is taking the first of F. Then we need to go with F. F is starting with G. Then we need to check for G. G has the first open parenthesis and ID. So first of E will be parenthesis and ID.
Very good. Next.
Then when it comes to E dash, ma'am, the production is starting with plus, so we can add it to the first of plus and first of e dash. So plus and minus t e dash gives first of e dash as minus and also epsilon.
Very good. I'll just do it, then hold for a minute. Okay. Plus, it is terminal, so that directly we are adding. Minus, it is and terminal, epsilon. Directly we are adding. Epsilon is terminal, we are adding. Yeah. Now, go ahead.
As we have already done the production of T, it is using G now, ma'am. So we can...
You start with F itself. T starts with F.
T starts with F and F starts with G. So the first of G is open parenthesis and ID, ma'am, which is same as E.
Copied. Yeah. Now come back to T dash.
Now T dash starts with first has star and division symbol and epsilon, ma'am. They are, all three are non-terminals.
Star. We need to look at all the times first symbols. T dash has three productions. So among each and every production, we are harvesting the terminal. I'm just recapping, nothing more. Don't worry. So star, division symbol, okay, epsilon. That's it. Now go ahead with F.
Ma'am, F starts with non-terminal G, ma'am. So G, when we look at the production of G, we have open parenthesis and ID, ma'am.
Let me copy as such. Now go ahead.
Now G dash has first as exponentiation and epsilon, ma'am.
Exponential and
epsilon.
Next.
G has
several times we visited. Several times. So copy paste. Thank you, Pavan. Thank you. Yeah. Now we are going for follow computation. You can chat. If anyone is feeling comfortable in audio note, you can give me audio note. If not, you come to the chat. Now you need to start with follow of E. You need to do quickly. Follow of E. Let us start. T first division is missing. 1 minute. Yeah, I would have missed the T. T first. T dash is star, not missing. I copy pasted, na? Yeah. Thank you, ma. Thank you, D4. Yeah. Follow of E. Come on first. Follow of capital E. As I used to mention, epsilon don't write EP. Write EP. Yeah. Follow, it won't have epsilon at all, first of all. Follow never ever will have epsilon, that we need to remember. Yeah, close bracket. Pavan, think once. What is the main miss? Yeah, dollar. Close bracket, dollar, comma, because it is starting symbol. So because of the starting symbol, we need to mandatorily put dollar, then close bracket. Now let us see. 1 minute, close bracket. Now let us see how it has come. Dollar, as I mentioned, this is the starting symbol of the given grammar, capital E. So it is mandatory to include dollar. How it becomes close bracket would be your question. Look at E, where it is sitting E. This is the only place E is sitting here. See, position. You need to look at who is sitting very immediate to E. The person who is sitting very immediate to E is close bracket. He is a terminal. So we need to write that capital, sorry, close bracket. Someone may need to unmute. Someone may need to unmute. 1 minute. Yeah, so that I have included dollar and close bracket. That's it. Go ahead. E dash follow. E dash follow. Same close. Same, I can copy paste, but explanation is required. This is a bit tricky. Look at E dash is available here. Nobody is followed by E dash. This is scenario 2. E dash is available here. E dash is available here. All the three places, the scenario says nothing is followed. That is empty, epsilon. Whenever it is empty, we need to include follow of this LHS. fall off e just now we have computed, so I am copying pasting. Similarly, we need to include fall off e dash also, e dash alls as well. But e dash we have not computed yet. What we can include? Nothing we can include. So that just we are ignoring the other two e dash. Otherwise, it is called always union. All the three places we need to do union operation. Union of that situation, union of this, union of this. But e dash already it is empty. So that we are just leaving. When we consider the first production, we have follow for LHS E. Just now we have computed. So that I have included. Very good. Now let us go ahead fast. T, follow of T. Yeah, no need to write this much, Pavan. Just write simply because it will take a lot of time for you. So dollar close bracket. Dollar close bracket. Let us see how it has come. Follow of T. Look at T. This is capital T. This is capital T. This also as well capital T. There are three circumstances we are having capital T. Who is followed by T in all the three circumstances? This is the person followed by this. He is sitting beside. Now we need to look at first of E dash. First of E dash has plus and minus. We need to write plus and minus as such. Plus and minus. Next, you need to substitute instead of that for follow of T E dash. You substitute this epsilon. This fellow will go. Then what will become? T followed by MT will become. When T followed by MT will become, you need to blindly include follow of E. Already follow of E, I am having these two, so I need to include these two person. This is what the complete follow of T. Pavan, could you understand now? You need to replace the first for every time. Then after replacing one symbol, you need to harvest the follow symbol. If it happens to become epsilon, that is different scenario. That's it. Now, let us go for T dash follow computation. T dash. Come on, guys. T dash follow. T dash is available here. T dash is available here. T dash is available here. Nobody is followed by T dash. Then what should become? Yeah. Follow of as such we need to copy. Follow of T. See, when T dash followed by nothing, I need to include follow of T. When T dash followed by nothing, I need to include follow of T dash, but T dash itself already having emptiness. So I need to just copy paste follow of T. Why? Because follow of T dash is nothing. When it is nothing or empty or epsilon, we need to consider follow of as such LHS left hand side. Go ahead, follow of F. Very good, D4. Follow of F. Make it fast, ma. See, look at follow of F. F is available here, one circumstance. F is available here, one circumstance. First, we need to look. F is available here, another circumstance. F is available here, another circumstance. So there are several circumstances we need to consider. First, let us start with this. See, this is also same. This is also same. This is also same. All the three places F is followed by T dash. That is one scenario. There is another scenario. F is followed by nothing. Let us start with this. If we solve this one, remaining all we no need to worry. Now let us look at F is followed by T dash. What I supposed to do? Look at T dash first. Whatever symbol available, I need to substitute first. Star, put star here. Slash, put slash here. Then harvest all the follow symbol. Then put epsilon. What would happen? Follow of T. So that follow of T I need to copy. In additions, star and slash I need to put. That's it. Nothing more we can do. Star, comma, division I need to include. Nothing more we can do. However, we solve for this problem, all the possible terminals we have harvested. Beyond that, we can't do anything. So we no need to revisit all other symbol at all. Now let's go ahead. G dash. Who is followed by, follow of G dash. Follow of G dash. Same, exactly. Follow of G dash is nothing, empty. When it becomes empty, we need to include follow of F. This person who whatever holds follow, we need to take a copy of it. Just now we have computed follow of F. I need to simply copy and paste. No more job. Now follow of G. See, look at G is available only one situation, one occurrence. G is followed by G dash. I need to look at G dash first. Substitute this cap symbol in place of G dash. Then G dash. Then if I substitute empty F, then it is going to become follow of F union this cap symbol, exponential symbol. Exponential symbol also will come. Okay. Now we need to include follow of F, not G, Pavan, because first substitute this cap symbol in place of G dash. Because we are looking at the follow of G, then what we need to consider? Substitute this cap symbol here. Then my follow would become first, very first is cap symbol. Then what I supposed to do? I need to substitute the second first epsilon. If I substitute epsilon, this term will become empty. Then G is followed by empty. In that circumstance, I need to include follow of capital F. Already I have follow of capital F. These all I can copy paste. Guys, could you get the point? If you have doubts, you can question. Yes, we can move further. D4, can you give audio note for table entry? Yes or no? D4, table filling entry, audio note. No answer. Why you are quiet? Say yes or no at least. D4. I'm asking you. Yeah, I could hear you. After that, there is no voice. Okay. You can now text in the chat box itself. If you are feeling audio quality poor, you can continue with the chat box. Okay. Let us confirm. See. What already I have filled answer, I'm just confirming with this, everything is right. So that I'm going to delete this table. Just for conformity, I was retaining this table. This before coming to your session, I have created. Now I'm going to delete. Everything have come right. Now we need to go ahead with table filling. Now for this table filling, I need to reduce the page. Only then all will come in a single page. What to do? Okay, I'll do one thing. I'll include one more column, right? I merge this all cell and I'll copy paste this production so that it will become reduced. Now it sounds good for you. Now I just change the background color. Yeah, now quick we can do the table filling entry. This is what? Entry of the table. Now let us look ahead. That is not required. Grammar is available. First and follow is available as well. We need to go ahead. Now, while filling the table, all the time we need to consider the first. If the first having epsilon only, we are bothering about follow. Otherwise, for us, follow is not at all required. We no need to respect follow at all. when we need to look into follow means whenever the first is having epsilon, by that time we are taking into consideration of follow. Please remember this. Then now E, when I want to fill the entry, I need to look at first of E, open bracket and ID. There are two first, no epsilon, so that there is no value for this fellow. We no need to bother the follow at all in this scenario. Now I need to fill up the production. It says E production, open bracket and ID. Then E production is only one, E produces TE dash, open bracket I need to fill. Then ID I need to fill. Then whenever I am filling, it becomes, 1 minute, I change. I need to reduce the size because I'm not able to fit in. So I'll put 10. Yeah. Now first entry is completed. Let us look into the second, E dash. E dash, we should not bother this right now. We need to look at first. When we look at first, plus minus epsilon, three symbols are available. We need to consider first plus and minus, then we look into epsilon. Now plus, E dash and plus, row and column I need to consider at a time. Then which production? If you look at, there are three production, plus TE dash, minus TE dash, epsilon. I need to consider plus TE dash, copy, E dash and plus entry, you need to fill. Now this filling is also got over. Next, consider minus. Then I need to consider the second production, minus. Now I need to fill this entry, not that entry, because whichever having minus, that only I need to consider. Now let us look into epsilon. Now the problem comes. When epsilon comes, we don't have column having the epsilon label. Because of that situation only, we are going for these two columns, dollar and close bracket. What we supposed to do in it, we need to copy paste epsilon production, E dash produces epsilon, where we need to copy paste dollar and close bracket. Dollar is available here. Let me copy this epsilon. Then the same production I can copy where, close bracket. Where is the close bracket? Here. That's it. So now we have completed table 2 entry as well. When we consider T, we need to first look at the first computation, close bracket and ID. T has only one production. I need to copy paste in the column open bracket and in the column ID. Copy T open bracket, it has T ID, it has. I need to give entry in these two circumstances. Done. Next, T dash. If I look into T dash, there are three symbols. I need to consider these two primarily, then I can think of this. Similarly, if you look into T dash, there are three productions. Star, T dash and star pair. T dash is a row, star is a column. Then which production? The production which starts with the first, that only I need to copy. Next, another symbol is slash. Because of that, I need to consider T dash and slash column. I need to copy paste the subsequent production. The subsequent production is this. I need to copy paste this. Over. Now epsilon. Because of this occurrence of epsilon, I need to look at follow. Now this is my duty. I need to look at the follow column. Follow says me plus, minus, dollar, close bracket. There are four symbols. Plus, minus, dollar and dollar. Plus, minus, dollar and close bracket. I need to copy paste the production called T dash epsilon. Let me copy this and I will modify. Plus first. Let us put plus. I need to replace by T dash. T dash is the right production. Now one entry we have done. What is that entry? T dash plus. Next symbol says minus. I need to copy paste. Next symbol says dollar. look into the column, copy paste. Next symbol says close bracket. I need to copy paste. We are done. Now we need to look at G dash. G dash we need F. We need to look at F. F has only two entry. We are lucky. Open bracket, ID. When I look at the grammar corresponding to F also having only one. So what I supposed to do? I need to copy paste this grammar in the column open bracket and ID with the row F. So let me do that. F produce a GG dash. So F having open bracket, I need to place it. Then F having ID, the second one, F having ID, I need to place it. That's it. So the duty is over, filling the F table or F entry. Now we are going for G dash. G dash has two symbols, exponential symbol and epsilon. First, let me complete exponential symbol so that I need to copy this. Then corresponding column G dash and cap, I need to fill. Yes, I am filled. Next is epsilon. Because of this epsilon, there are six columns. See, look at, there are six symbol: star, division, plus, minus, dollar, close bracket. I need to copy the production G dash epsilon. Okay, first let me consider star, G dash and star. First I need to give G dash produces epsilon. I need to complete with epsilon. Then I can copy paste quickly. So one production is formed. One symbol we are done. Look at the next symbol, slash. I need to copy paste this production. Look at the next symbol, plus. I need to copy paste. Look at the next symbol, minus. I need to copy paste. Look at the next symbol, dollar. I need to copy paste. Close bracket. That's it. We are done. Next, G. G has only two symbols, open bracket and ID. So what we do, open bracket is of this production. We need to fill the column G open bracket with this production. Next, we need to fill the column GID with the GID production. G produces ID. That's all. These are all the table entry we have obtained right now. Hope so. You all would be clear. If you have doubt on this table entry, you can clarify now itself. All at a time I'm showing. See, table entry and the first and follow grammar table. Now our duty or this particular session is to discuss what to do with the rest of the people. There are so many empty. The primary concern is never the table should become empty is the primary concern. Now what to do is the question. That is what we are going to look at now. Guys, if you have doubts, you can clarify either audio note or text box. If you don't have, I can proceed with. Because we have only 10 more minutes, we need to complete that remaining syllabus. Even I cannot complete error recovery. Let me postpone to Friday. Then your MCQ question, I will come back later. I will discuss at the end of the session. Not now. Come back. Now, please sail with me for the first row, how I am doing. You guys need to unmute and tell me subsequent rows. First row only I will explain you how that empty rows I am going to fill up. First row or couple of rows, at least two rows I will take. Look at first row. Look at, now you need to look at the follow symbol. Follow symbol of first row. All the time you need to look at follow symbol. Whenever we started filling these entries like the productions. Whenever I copied the production, by the time I asked you to look into first, if the first has epsilon only, I insisted to look into follow. Remaining time, I didn't even bothered. I didn't even tell anything. Now, how I am filling the entry number one, please pay your attention because it is new topic. So for now, I was repeating the already explained topic. Now I am going for a new topic. Now we need to look at the person called follow. Follow has two symbols, dollar and close bracket. Point out, dollar and close bracket. These two entries are empty. We are lucky. Look at the follow symbol. Directly you look at the follow symbol. If that follow symbol is empty or filled already, that is what your question, two choice. Right now, both are empty. If it is empty, what I supposed to do is I need to write pop. I need to write pop. We are asking the stack to pop. Got it? Now I will fill up like this all the pop. Then I will, after pop filling, there will be an empty cells. How to fill that? Let us see later. Only this way you can understand better. Now look at this particular row E dash. Look at the follow symbol of E dash. Dollar and close bracket. Dollar and close bracket already filled. I don't have to do anything else because already it is filled. That's all. No more work for me right now with second this particular row. Now let us look into T. T, I need to look at all the follow symbols. Plus, minus, dollar, close bracket. T, plus is empty, minus is empty, dollar is empty, close bracket is also empty. All the symbols are empty. Now, one by one, what I supposed to do? I need to write pop. Either capital, I can write. This would be easier for you to read pop. Now, let us look at one by one. Plus, plus is empty, put pop. Minus is empty, put pop. Dollar is empty, give pop. Close bracket is entry, assign pop. Done. Now, look into T dash. There are four cells. Plus, minus, dollar, close bracket. Plus, minus, dollar, close bracket. All the columns are filled already, entered by something. So I can't do anything. Look at the next production. F plus empty slash empty plus star empty minus empty dollar empty and close bracket empty. I need to give pop pop. First let me fix the row. F star column pop, then close bracket pop, plus pop, minus pop, dollar pop, close bracket pop. That's all. If I commit any mistake while copying, you ping me. Otherwise I proceed. Look at G dash. These are all the follow. Star already filled, slash already filled, plus already filled, minus already filled, dollar already filled, close bracket already filled. Simple, whenever epsilon is there, that all already filled. If there is no epsilon only, we need to fill. Very simple. But I want to demonstrate to you every time. Look at, when this doesn't have epsilon, these all columns would become empty. Naturally, it will be empty. See, look at close bracket, cap. I need to put pop. Star, I need to put pop. Close bracket, I need to put pop. Plus, pop. Minus, pop. Dollar, pop. Close bracket, pop. Guys, do you have got doubt with pop? How I am assigning? All the time I need to look at the corresponding follow. If the follow entry, that column is not empty, we no need to worry. If it is empty only, we need to fill up pop. Still, there are several entries are empty. How we are going to fill up is the next curious question. Do you have any doubt with pop? If there is no signal, I understand that you are all comfortable. Now, wherever this is free, I need to write skip. These kind of instance comes, no? We are going to do skip operation. Skip, 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 skip. Guys, could you able to understand? All the empty cells, either it will have pop or it will have skip. first work for POP. After that, you can easily do your job with the filling skip. That's all about filling the entry for error recovery strategies. This is the very primary step. After this table, if I start explaining the theoretical part, you all would be understanding much better. That how I am going to do error recovery strategies, let me explain on Friday, because slowly let us go. You need to understand ultimately, that is what primary concern. So Friday we can do. If you have got doubt, you can clarify. Otherwise, first let me stop the recording, then you can communicate whatever you wish to.